ecology. Last time we looked at all the definitions, and from the previous, exercise, other homework given, we are taught to define some terminologies which are found under ecology. Felt like we go through again through some important diagrams so that we get to understand more. So we are looking at feeding relationships and energy flow. We have number three there. We are taught to say, design a food chain. Design a food chain. The answer is that food chain, we have a plant which is being eaten by a rabbit. Then a rabbit is also being eaten by a fox. That is a food chain. Maybe go there. Do we have food chain? Do we have food chain? Okay, there's no term for food chain, but it was defined in another material we used last time. Then there's another question where we have design a food web. Food web, the answer is this. We have, let me bring it there. We have a rabbit. A rabbit which eats grass or plants. A rabbit can be eaten by foxes. A rabbit also can be eaten by hooks and oars. That is the food web. Then we also have what is known as a squirrels. Squirrels are eaten by foxes, the owls. That is what we have. Then we have the mice. We have the foxes, the owls, and whereas the snakes, they also eat mice. Then we have seed-eating birds. Seed-eating birds, they do feed on plants, but they can also be eaten by those animals on top. We also have herbivores. Herbivores, herbivorous insects, which feed on plants, can be eaten by the spider. They also, the insectivorous birds, the birds that feed on the insects. We also have predaceous insects that eat on the other insects, which can also be eaten by the frogs. The same insects can also be eaten by snakes. That is what we have. So this is what we have, or this is the meaning of food web. We have the next point where we have described the way energy flows along food chain. Describe the way energy flows along food chain. Describe the way energy flows along the food chains and also the food web. Food webs, we have the answer is energy flows, or energy from the sun is converted into chemical energy that other organisms can eat as food. This means that it is transferred through the entire food chain until it reaches the topmost consumers. That is what we have. Energy from the sun, it is trapped and converted into chemical energy that other organisms can eat as food. Okay, that is what we have under that. Then from there, we have described the efficiency of energy transfer between trophic levels. The answer is that in the process of being transferred from the trophic level to another, energy is also lost. That is correct. How does this take place? Other uses after an herbivore eats some food, it produces feces. So the energy in the undigested food is not passed on to the primary carnivores, which are at the next trophic level. The remaining chemical energy, which is food, is used by the herbivore for a number of functions such as the cellular respiration, tissue repair, food, body movement, and also cell divisions and also growth. This is correct. So some energy is lost in the process due to the feces which are produced by the animals. So it's not the entire energy which is transferred to another level or trophic level. Other one, it is lost on the way, just as it has been explained. The ratio of energy the ratio of energy at one level compared to the next higher level is called the conversion efficiency. So we have 10% as the average conversion efficiency from one trophic level to the other. 10% is as the average conversion efficiency from one trophic level to another. That is what we have there. Then construct pyramids of numbers, biomass, and also energy. Answer: the pyramids are graphic representations of the relative amounts of energy or matter at each trophic level. May be energy pyramid, biomass pyramid, or pyramid of numbers. So the pyramid are in three ways: energy pyramid, biomass pyramid, or pyramid of numbers. Let's look at pyramid of numbers. Pyramid of numbers, these allow you to compare the number of organisms present in each trophic level at a particular time. They are usually upright, but may be upside down. For example, we have this diagram there, where we have, let's look at the number of plants. The number of plants, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm seeing 7. We go to the animals there, which are the giraffes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have a lion. The lion is 1. That is a pyramid of numbers. The biomass pyramid, what is it all about? This shows the amount of dry mass at each trophic level. This refers to that dry mass at each trophic level. What do we have? We have the first one where we have the plants there, 1,500 grams of grain. That is 1,500 grams of grain. Then we have 500 grams of chicken. And finally, we have 50 grams of human being. 50 grams of. This is the pyramid or the biomass. That is the biomass we have looked at there. Then we go to energy pyramid. Pyramid of energy allows us to compare the amount of energy passing through each trophic level. They are usually upright. We have the ecosystem energy flow. We have the producers. Here we have the producer at the bottom there. We have the sunlight. We are also seeing the plant there where I'm pointing. Then we have the first trophic level. Then we have the herbivore there. We have the insect primary consumer. They are the ones known as the primary consumers. Second trophic level. Then we have the carnivores, which are the secondary consumers. And we have the carnivores again. carnivores, which are the tertiary consumers. The fourth topic level, we have the second, the third topic level, the second, and the first. If we go to the other diagram here, we have the amount of energy stored per unit time. We have the first level, we have the second topic level, we have the fourth topic level. That is what we have. Then we go to a question which is known as population or population. Explain the term population. Population means different species in a community. Different species in the same community. We had this lesson yesterday. I want to believe you still remember. Investigate factors that cause change in population size. What are the factors that cause change in population size? We have factors that lead to change, include natural disasters, disease, migration, immigration, and wars. Carbon and nitrogen water cycle. Question number 19 has been answered. The factors that lead to the change in population include natural disasters. We have also diseases. Animals may move from one place to another because of the diseases or because of natural disasters or also because of just migrating or immigrating, coming in, population may increase or may reduce where the animals are coming from. And also wars. Wars, when there are wars, population may reduce or may increase to the place where there is no war. So the carbon and also the nitrogen cycle. Describe how carbon and nitrogen are cycled within an ecosystem. So what we have is this. We have the nitrogen. Okay, we have the nitrogen there. Nitrogen fixation kind of bacteria. Then we have the regime symbiosis. We have the plant proteins there, decomposition, animal proteins there. We have the nutrients for that animal, animal waste, urea. We have bacteria there, which comes there, they decompose, decomposition. We also have assimilation, which they are used by plants. Okay, then nitrification. Then we have the next one where we have the, what do we have here? We have air and water there, which is carbon dioxide, cellular respiration. Oh, let me move first to, let me move clockwise direction. Remember, we are now looking at the carbon cycle. The carbon cycle. We have photosynthesis, which is chiefly plants. We have the alga. Then we have the organic compounds there, which we have at the bottom there. We have the cellular respiration, burning, decay. We have the consumed by heterotrophs, which is chiefly animals. We have the organic compounds of heterotrophs, cellular respiration. Then we have the carbon cycle itself. This is the carbon cycle. We have the calcium carbonate there, or the limestone, which is coal or oil. Then we have the consumed by the heterotrophs, which is the chief animals. So this is the carbon cycle. That is the carbon cycle. Then we go to describe what the water cycle is. Water cycle, we have the sun. It is heating the water. Water evaporates. Also, transpiration takes place. Then transpiration from evaporation, it goes to, it forms clouds, then it rains. Impervious rock layers, we have also the rock layers which do cannot allow the water to pass through. So this is the water cycle. This is the water cycle. The other question is to investigate key features of ecosystem. The key features of ecosystem is that the features of an ecosystem, community, and non-living part of the environment. Use a pond as an example. We use a pond as an example. Investigate key features of an ecosystem. When you go into a pond, you find that in a pond there are a lot of things which are found there. Features of an ecosystem, those are the community and also the non-living part of the environment. For example, we have a pond. A pond, we find the non-living organisms and also other organisms which are living. Explain the effects of agriculture on the ecosystem. Agriculture may lead to water, soil, and air pollution. That one we agree. Describe the effects of deforestation on soil stability and climate. Effects of deforestation, soil erosion, global warming. That deforestation may lead to soil erosion and also global warming. May also lead to global warming. Pollution. Describe the undesirable effects of pollution. Undesirable effects of pollution on water, air, and land. Pollution has got effects on water, air, and also the land. Then determine measures to prevent pollution. Measures to prevent pollution. Number one, we have to manage the waste. The waste has to be managed. Then we have to use of the filter in sinks, include the conversion of sulfur dioxide to sulfuric acid by passing it through a tank of water. Then we have conservation. Conservation, identify the importance of conserving plant and also animal species. Importance of conserving plant and animal species is that it helps to maintain biodiversity and also helps to prevent endangered species from going into extinction. So there is need to conserve, which is to protect, plants and also animals, but they may not go into extinction. Extinction, this simply means to disappear. The idea is not to make plants disappear. It is not good to make plants disappear. Explain how toy use reduce and explain how to reuse, reduce and recycle materials. Okay, this we have the three others, which is the reduce, and also we have the reuse, and also we have what is known as the recycle. Investigate the importance of sustainable use of resources. Sustainable use of resources, avoid deforestation, overfishing, overhunting, encourage game keeping. That is the only way we can sustain resources. It is by discouraging deforestation, overfishing, and also overhunting, and also we have to encourage game keeping, keeping of animals. There is what we call biodiversity. In our next video, we'll look at instead of the next video, let's try to finish it. Biodiversity, we are looking at investigate the diversity of organisms in a given locality. Investigate the importance of diversity of organisms in given locality. Answer, equilibrium of organisms in the ecosystem. That is what we have, equilibrium of organisms in the ecosystem. Importance of diversity of organisms in a given locality, it leads to equilibrium of organisms in the ecosystem. Explain how some organisms are adapted to the environment. Adaptive characteristics of fish, insects, mammals, and plants. Okay. We have number three question. Investigate the impact of human activities on organisms. Impact of human activities on organisms refer to hunting. Those are the activities of human beings. Fishing are the activities and the charcoal production. Also refer to the threatened extinction of the African elephant. Yeah, elephants have gone into extinct because of hunting, because of human activity. Describe the economic reasons for maintaining biodiversity. What is biodiversity, by the way? Biodiversity, what is it all about? So let's go to number four. Describe the economic reasons for maintaining biodiversity. For tourism, medical plants, and also the animal source of food. So if you maintain bio, or if biodiversity is being maintained, meaning it may lead to attracting tourists, and also the medical plants. If plants are being maintained, meaning there will be plenty of medical plants, and also animals, and also source of food. So those are the things which will happen. There's a question which is biodiversity. Biodiversity refers to the variety of different species of plants, also animals and microorganisms that live in an ecosystem or on earth as a whole. It also includes the genetic diversity within each species, the variety of ecosystems and the interactions between different species and their environments. Biodiversity is important for many reasons, including ecosystem services, which is biodiversity, provides many essential services. So we have already looked at that one. So basically, biodiversity refers to the variety of different species of plants, animals, and also microorganisms that live in an ecosystem on Earth. Thank you so much. We end here. Thank you.